Welcome to the Felix Smart Studio. This is the first video in a three-part series about how to build a completely scalable, automated hydroponic system. In this video, I will be explaining what supplies you need and how to acquire them. If you already know of and have all the supplies you need, then click on this video, which will also be linked down in the description. This system is extremely simple and doesn't require any prior knowledge. In fact, I'm brand new to the Felix Smart team and my boss asked me to make this video just to show me how easy it is to build a hydroponic system. So I'm gonna kind of be learning along with all of you watching. So yesterday we actually ran out to the store to grab some supplies. And while we roll some of that footage, I'll be walking you through a quick cost breakdown of how much you can expect to spend on this system, as well as how long it will likely take to pay itself off. Keep in mind, these are very rough estimates. So I just kind of want to demonstrate the potential massive output of this system. Taking into account all of the different associated costs for this build, before automation for this 3-tier, 6x2-foot hydroponic system, I estimated that we'll end up spending just under $1,400. Please keep in mind that I took the absolute highest estimates I could find for every single item and rounded way up. We're using the highest quality materials available, but you could easily trim costs wherever is practical in your situation. For example, I also calculated a low-end estimate that involves a reduction in only two of the highest costs, the rack and the grow lights. With a do-it-yourself rack and cheaper grow lights, this estimate came out to just under $900 Canadian. Get creative with cost saving if price feels like a limiting factor for you. This design is totally customizable. To completely automate this system, we will be using Kai, the Felix Smart Controller. Acquiring the hydroponic kit will increase our high estimate cost to just under $2,700 and our low estimate cost to just under $2,200. This portion of the cost is quickly recovered due to the vast amount of time saved on labor. Now here's the crazy part. Using very conservative estimates of current produce growth periods and prices, I found these results. Using the high cost estimate and taking into account recurring costs like water and plant food at 10 cents per plant, electricity at $9 per month, and growing pods at $20 per month. Growing exclusively lettuce in your system for 1 year will produce savings of just under $1,250. Despite this being the same year as our initial investment, that gives us a savings margin of 28%. In year two, this savings margin grows exponentially to 90% and nearly $4,000 in savings. Now, obviously, no one can eat hundreds of pounds of lettuce, and no, that is not a challenge. But you can have a live salad bar in your house, mixing and matching your favorite veggies. Global food prices are on the rise, and the best way to mitigate unreasonable produce costs is a hydroponic system. Not to mention, your produce is gonna come out fresher and tastier than anything you can find in stores. All right, our shopping trip is complete and I will quickly run you through exactly what we picked up for this build. We got a sturdy rack to be the foundation of our system. We got 9 4-foot long full spectrum grow lights, 3 for each level of our system. We are using top quality Barina grow lights, but there are many more cost-effective options for this build. We will also be using long zip ties to secure the lights to the rack for this project. We got 3 large trays made of food safe plastic. These will be the containers that our water flows through and our plants float on. We will also be drilling a hole in the bottom of each one of these tubs to allow downward flow of water into each level of our system. If you do not have a drill handy, there are other ways to get this hole out, except they will be extremely time consuming. We got 1 very large tub made of food safe plastic. This acts as a reservoir and sits underneath our rack. We got 3 styrofoam plant rafts. We are using plant rafts from Beaver Plastics and we highly recommend this product, but alternatively, if you're looking to save some money, you could come up with something involving maybe a styrofoam sheet and mesh cups. We got 3 small clip-on fans. This helps to cool down the system as well as keep pesky bugs from sitting comfortably on the leaves. We have 20 feet of 5/8-inch tubing as well as 1 elbow joint and 3 plugs. These tubes will transport and circulate water throughout our system. The amount required will vary depending on how many levels you have in your system. So we're going to need 1 tube going from the reservoir at the base up to the top of the rack, 1 tube connecting from that one to our first tray, 1 tube from our first tray down to our second tray, 1 tube from our second tray down to our third tray, and lastly, 1 tube from our third tray down to the bottom of the reservoir. it is definitely best to wait to measure out and cut these lengths exactly to what you need. Our three plugs are so that we can more securely guide water from one tray to the next. You will also need seeds, a growing medium or container of some sort, be it mesh cups, coconut core, grow pods, etc. We are using grow pods, liquid plant food, and of course, the hydroponic grow kit from Felix Smart. This includes pre-calibrated water probes and air monitors that measure acidity, total dissolved solids, water and air temperature, water level, electroconductivity, and humidity. It includes a camera that allows you to remotely monitor your plants and create time lapses with ease. It also includes Kai, the Felix Smart controller. Lastly, I will talk about the three different types of pumps we're using for this system. We got a submersible water pump. You can use many different types of pumps for this project. Just ensure that your gallons per hour rating is high enough to actually boost the water as high as you want it to go. For us, we're going up about 6 feet, so we went with the pump that has 396 gallons per hour rating, or 1500 liters per hour. We got an air pump. This pump helps to oxygenate the water, which helps to prevent the buildup of algae and diseases to grow. It also helps the plants to better soak up the nutrients in the water. Finally, we got a peristaltic pump. This pump contributes to the total automation process for our system. It automatically doses our reservoir with the required amount of nutrients for our plants to thrive without us having to do anything manually. That covers all of the supplies required for this hydroponic build. If you have any questions or comments, please be sure to let us know down below. We would really love to hear from you. Beyond that, we would really appreciate if you left a like on this video and subscribe to the channel, but only if you found value in this content. Now, if you are content with your supply list, please be sure to click this video to continue your journey with your hydroponic build. I'll see you there.